All right, guys, so I just dove in. I just figured this is the last piece, might as well. I cleaned it, so now, I don't know if you notice, of all the pieces, this is the only one, and this is the headboard, that has the veneer all chipped. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my quick wood, and I'm gonna fill in those areas. I got two there. I got a missing strip there. Got some nicks. So we're just gonna fill that in before we sand this bad boy. All right. So I think I need to keep that on the video. My video's running.
I didn't know that.
All right, y'all. So I have patched up all of my areas. My technique is not the best. I'm not good at that spatula thing. Like, it just does not spread the way I like it to, so I kind of just pack it in with my finger, and then once it dries, then I will sand it and even it out. Now you'll notice on this side, I left the top alone because it's such an even mistake, I guess, that once I paint over it, you're not going to be able to tell. But all those little patches, because since the veneer is so thick, like, you could actually see it, like, be uneven. So that's why I patched up these areas. But I left that one alone because since it's an even mistake, it's just like, whatever, right? So, all right, we're doing well. All right, guys, so I'm gonna start working on this. If you notice, I legit took the veneer off the entire front, partially off the side, and completely off of the other side. I did that because that quick wood that I was using, I did not mix the epoxy well. And 3 days, y'all, and it just was not drying. So I just took the veneer off. So now we're gonna prime it because I am so ready to be done with this project. I have so many other things that I have to do and I have to get this done. So I ran out of rollers. Hence why I'm using a brush. I think it's taking so long, but I don't feel like going to Lowe's. Just don't. Majority of it has been primed. Not the best prime job, but this sucker's getting painted black, so it don't matter to me. Plus, I also have to sand it in between to get all, like, the rough bits off. But this side that's sealed, I have to wait till that side dries so that I can slide the doors over and then paint the inside of this side. Makes sense?
Yeah.
Because there's a track, and since I put primer in the track, every time I move the doors, it just like rips off the wet primer, so we just have to wait. So I guess we could chit chat for a little bit while I'm waiting for my pieces to dry. So this is probably going to be a really long vlog, and I don't want that, but it is what it is, okay? So I had an issue with my drawers last night. I had painted them. I had sanded them. I had cleaned them. I had sanded them. I had primed them, painted them. 2 coats of polyurethane. Like, they were okay. They were almost done. They were ready. And I felt that it was humid out. And I'm like, you know what? I should really bring these in. And I didn't listen to my gut. Why do I do that to myself? My gut speaks to me. And I don't listen to it. And so I'm doing some things in the house, and I open the back door to check, and when I see my cement and I see those little water marks all over my cement, I said, oh my God, my drawers. So lo and behold, I think you saw the footage already. The rain ruined the polyurethane because it wasn't completely dry. So there was all these little white spots. And then when I woke up the next day, because I was like, I'm not even going to deal with this now, okay? When I woke up the next day, aka today, from afar, I was like, oh my God, they're fine. They're good. That's the devil, okay? They weren't fine. From afar, they looked great. But when you come close, you could see all the little circles from all the rain droplets, and I'm not about that. Like, if I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it right. So I just finished resanding the drawers because I had to take off the polyurethane, resanded it, rebuffed them because now they were like, you know, whatever, gritty, and repainted them. So I'm waiting right now because I think one of the issues that I'm having is I'm trying to work a little bit too fast, and I am not giving the paint or the primer or whatever polyurethane, I'm not giving those chemicals enough time to cure. Not just a wait time. Hallelujah. Lord, you're speaking right now. Yes, you are. So I wasn't waiting the appropriate amount of time that I'm supposed to wait. For instance, the primer, you're supposed to wait 45 minutes for it to fully cure. But most people say, just leave that sucker overnight so that you really get the best, product. So that's what I'm doing. I am practicing patience. I'm not going to lie. I'm very frustrated, very annoyed. A lot about this house aggravates me. I mean, you can still see that my fridge is here. Okay. I don't know when you're watching this, but I'm filming it at the end of September. Y'all, I moved in at the beginning of September, and stuff is still not where it needs to be. So we're still living out of boxes. It's still a mess. I'm still wearing the same old t-shirts day in and day out. Haven't been able to get my hair done. I'm just a mess, and I'm frustrated, and I'm aggravated. I wake up angry, I go to sleep angry, and I'm just trying to push through. I really am.
I'm in it for the love.
post-production commentary. Black is tough, guys, especially with something that has like doors, like railing. You can see I'm already getting chipping here. I've got chipping across this. I got some nicks here, right? I got nicks here. So it is a challenge to work with black paint. So if anybody has any advice on something I could use to kind of stop these nicks from occurring, especially on the track, please comment below, let me know. Overall, I mean, I'm proud of myself. You know, it's supposed to be a queen size and we're making it work for a king size. These little end tables are actually supposed to fit flush into it, but I don't care. I'm good with that little space. It kind of gives it character. So it is what it is, y'all. It is what it is.